Hey, how can I help you?
I have some Harry S. Truman signed books dedicated to his chief economist, Leon Kaiserling.
You're into economics, or?
I'm an economist.
Okay.
Yeah.
Got any stock tips?
No. I came down to the pawn shop today to sell my Truman autographed books. They've basically been sitting on my bookshelf for the last 20 years. I'm looking to get $3,000 for them, and I think that would be the least I would take.
It's really neat that he signed these. We have them inside the book and in the box it came in.
Mrs. Kaiserling gave me the books.
So do you know what the books are about?
There's two volumes of the memoirs.
And Mr. Citizen.
Mm-hmm.
What's Mr. Citizen about?
That's about his job after the presidency.
Okay. I mean, he was just a normal guy. He was a senator from Missouri. Before he was that, he ran a haberdashery, a hat store.
That's right.
Harry Truman was only vice president for 82 days. He became our 33rd president after FDR died in office. He did have some major accomplishments. He did stop the United States from going back into the Great Depression after the war was over. But he's probably best remembered for being the only president ever to drop an atomic bomb. These books are incredible. They're awesome. I would love to actually read them. The Atom and the War. It was my fate to make the decisions to use the first atomic bomb to bring about the end of a terrible war. I'm sure he saw this as an opportunity, hoping it would stop the war with the Japanese. Probably one of the more difficult presidencies there ever was. Harry Truman was a very important person in American history. If these books were really signed by him, they're definitely something that history buffs and rare book collectors would go nuts for. So what do you want to do with them?
I think I'll sell them.
Do you have an idea what you wanted for them?
I haven't done a lot of research. So, you know, at the moment, I'm thinking maybe 3,000.
I'm definitely interested. I'm wildly interested. There might be a lot of money here. I have a friend who's an incredible rare book expert, and she's gonna really help us with the price on these things.
I am not questioning the authenticity of the books at all, and I'm very pleased that they're going to be calling in an expert.
Rebecca, how's it going?
Hey, nice to see you, Rick. The guys usually call me when they've got a book, they don't know much about it, they need an expert to come in and give them a real value.
We have some really cool books here. We have one Mr. Citizen, and the first two books are his memoirs. All signed by Truman. I've had the signatures check out. They're all legit. What they're worth, that's why I came to you.
Truman's presidency, some of the major events of the 20th century occurred. Mao's communist China was formed, the Iron Curtain was dropped, and NATO was created. So this is, by any standard, one of the major presidencies of the 20th century. Presidential memoirs are hugely sought after because collectors love these leaders of men. When you have a presentation copy like this, you have to keep in mind not only who it's inscribed to, but the substance in the inscription. These things will all affect the value.
Okay.
To Honorable Leon Kaiserling, from his long-term friend who appreciates a real economist who understands the needs of this great nation. Now, Kaiserling, he had a huge amount of influence in the U.S. government at this time because he was the chairman of the Council of Economic Advisors. So this is a great inscription. That is a game changer as far as the value is concerned.
Okay.
So normally, Mr. Citizen, if it were just a signed copy of the author's edition, you'd be looking at about $2,500. Okay. The memoirs, they would actually go together for about $3,200 signed.
Okay.
But with this inscription here in the Mr. Citizen, I would bump this up to $4,000.
Okay.
Okay. And I would bump up the memoirs with the additional signature on the slipcase up to about $7,000.
Wow.
Okay, so that's $11,000. Wow.
I was very surprised about the value of the books. I had said $3,000, which was nowhere in the ballpark.
So do you mind if we conduct a little business in here?
I'll rent the room to you.
Okay.
The seller's got to be pretty happy after hearing my $11,000 appraisal, because that's a big difference from what she was asking before.
So you originally wanted like $2,000 or $3,000?
Three, I thought it was. Crazy.
Okay. All right. You realize I have to make a profit off these.
Yes, I do. I was an economics professor.
Okay. I'll just get to the heart of the matter. I'll give you $5,500 for it.
55 seems a little low to me, even with the profit. I'm thinking on the order of 10.
No. I'm going to have my money tied up for at least a year. 65?
Can't do 65. I think the best I could do would be somewhere in the neighborhood of 95.
I go 75, that would be it.
I just don't think I can do it at 75, but I thank you.
All right, well, thanks anyway.
We weren't able to make a deal today. The economy is improving at the moment, so the only thing I can think is that the value of the books will be even higher in the future than they are now.